Batteries are important. They basically run all of our portable electronics. I've taken apart a couple power banks recently, and they've all had these large centrifugal lithium ion batteries inside. Today we have a newcomer, a new contestant, the Crave Plus, that is a much thinner and sleeker profile. Today we're going to take this thing apart and see what makes it different from the larger centrifugal batteries. Thanks to Crave for sending this out. Now let's see what this thing is made of. Like you saw, lithium batteries come in two basic shapes and sizes, from the non-removable square batteries we see inside of cell phones to the cylindrical batteries we see inside of charging banks, electric cars, or even that massive Hornsdale battery system powering 30,000 homes in South Australia. Batteries are everywhere, and lithium batteries are impressive. Lithium, the element inside most of these batteries, is found in igneous rocks, you know, the ones from volcanoes. But the largest producers of lithium in the world is Chile, which extracts it from huge pastel-covered brine pools. I'm guessing this aluminum-covered Crave Plus power bank has a lithium polymer battery inside, which is the same thing that we see inside of most cell phones, but fits a 10,000 mAh battery life in a footprint about the same size as the iPhone 8 Plus. So as most electronics are moving over to USB-C from the micro USB, this Crave Plus power charger has two ways of charging. It has a micro USB in along with a USB-C in, which doubles as a USB-C out to charge your USB-C electronics, and a regular USB port for your iPhones and stuff. It does have quick charging for those phones that have that enabled, and it can be charging the power bank and a cell phone at the same time. Let's see what happens when we bump it up to two cell phones at the same time. We'll use my Galaxy S8, and it looks like we are charging the power bank and charging two separate devices at the same time. That's pretty sweet. Some power banks don't do that. Lithium-ion batteries have a relatively high energy density, but are very safe unless punctured. There are no visible screws around the aluminum enclosure, but popping off the end caps reveals the circuit board, two screws that I can undo to remove the silver cap, and then I can slide the whole contraption out the backside of the aluminum housing. These things aren't meant to be taken apart. It's very tightly glued together and will never fall apart on its own. As we can see, this sleek looking power bank is using a dual pouch style battery, two batteries stacked on top of each other, which is a pretty efficient use of space. And that's what Crave is after, making their power bank about the same size as an iPhone 8 Plus, but with three times the capacity. So internally, both of these batteries are built about the same way. If you've ever seen the What's Inside a Tesla battery made by the What's Inside YouTube channel, when they hack open one of these cylindrical cells, you can see the anode and cathode layers wrapped around each other. The same build style as inside of these pouch batteries. If you remember from my Note 7 video, when I tore open one of those batteries to see what it was made of, it had the different anode cathode layers as well. The reason Tesla uses these cylindrical batteries inside of their cars is because they're way easy to manufacture and mass produce. And Tesla utilizes the wasted space around these cylindrical batteries by putting in a cooling system, which allows them to push the batteries beyond their normal limits. For sleek, portable, high-capacity travel-size power banks, though, I think this pouch style is most ideal. Thanks to Crave for sending me out this power bank to review from the inside and take apart. I'll toss a link down in the video description if you want to check out the current pricing or if you want to get one for yourself. If you have any questions about power banks or batteries in general, leave them down in the comments. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.